subscribe to Nykaa TV and press the bell icon to make sure you never miss an update from us.
Getting older might come with its own set of challenges, but looking good should not be one of them. Hi everyone, I'm Deepal Haria and welcome back to our Mature Skin series, wherein I'll be showing you everything that you need to know to ace your makeup skills when it comes to mature skin. Today is all about festive glam makeup look that moms can do for any function. So let's get started. As you see that I've already prepped and primed her skin and done her entire base makeup. And if you want to know how I achieved this flawless look, you must watch my previous video. And the link is mentioned in the description box. I believe that eyebrows frame the face. So for doing the eyebrows, I'm going to use the K-Beauty Eyebrow Pencil in the shade Chestnut. I always love to start my eyebrows from the center. The reason is because sometimes you do not have enough control on your hand and you tend to deposit extra product. So as soon as you get some control, you can go in the start and apply your eyebrow pencil over there. Always try to go in the direction of the hair of the eyebrow. So when the hair is going slant, I will go in that direction. When it's going down, I'll go that way, and over here it's upwards, so I'll take my pencil in that direction. As you see, while I'm applying the eyebrows, I'm holding it from here so that I get the perfect shape. I'm not darkening it too much, but just filling it well. As you can see that just with a few strokes, it transforms and frames the face. Moving to the eyes, I'm first going to conceal the eyes using the Faces Stick Concealer. I'm doing this so that I can avoid any discoloration on the eye. You can just take a brush and apply it on the eyelids. And you can take it up and also in the corners. This step is very important if you want your eyeshadow to pop. For the eyes, I'm going to use some neutral tone as well as some highlight tones. For the eyeshadow, I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution eyeshadow palette. First things first, I'm going to apply some neutral tones on her crease line. The shade name is Running Late. For doing the crease, you can use colors like any pinks, peaches, browns, any neutral tones which are matte. You use matte colors because you do not want your crease to be extremely highlighted. You want your eyelid to be highlighted and not the crease. This trick is not just for mature skin. Even if you are doing makeup on yourself or anyone else, this trick absolutely works. Just make sure that you are using a brush which is fluffy. When you see I'm doing the crease, I'm taking it into circular motions. And very small circular motion so that it can blend off very well. Next, I'm moving on to my eyelid. And for the eyelids, I'm going to use a highlight shade, for which I'm going to take the Last Sun from the Makeup Revolution palette. So this is a golden color. You can also use bronze colors or silver colors as substitutes. So you can, that's your personal choice. You can take whichever shade you like. I feel like since this is a festive look, a little highlight on the eye looks beautiful. And if you see that she's wearing a green and pink with a little gold tinge in her outfit, so you can use golds. Whenever you're applying any eyeshadow, make sure that you are using a flat brush. Next, I'm going to take a soft brown color, which is the cheesecake, nice, and the chocolate orange for the contouring. We do the contouring usually just to add some depth in the eyes, and it's done only in the outer corner. Eyeliner needs to be applied very carefully on mature skin because most of you know that the eyes have a lot of wrinkles and fine lines. So understanding the right technique is very important. It's no rocket science. So for the liner, I'm going to use the Kiko Milano gel liner. I'm taking an eyeliner brush. Just take the product onto the brush. While doing the liner, it is very important to hold the eye from the eyebrow and also from the corner so that all the creases open up and the liner application becomes very smooth. So whenever I do liner, I choose to do it from the center. Again, the same technique as the eyebrow, because I do not want excess deposition in the inner corner. So I start from the center, go inside and connect it to the center. I'd suggest that you should avoid using kajal pencils for doing liners because it can get extremely messy and it's very difficult to clean it later. So you can either use a gel liner or maybe a pen liner. I think that works the best. Lashes are meant for anyone and everyone. You do not have to be afraid of applying lashes. If you feel that your client is not comfortable, you can go for natural lashes as well. So for today, I'm taking the Nykaa Melodrama lashes for her. I'm applying the lash glue on the tip of the lash. Make sure that you apply it well towards the corners. You can let it dry for a few seconds and then start applying the lashes. Start from the center, just stick it on the center and then connect it to the corners. Just ask your client to keep her eyes closed for a few minutes. Stick it well. You can also use your finger to give the curl. Open your eyes. Just pull the eyes when she opens it. Initially, your client might feel a little heavy and sticky on the eye, but that's completely fine because it's very natural. It'll be fine very soon. So after applying the lashes, do not forget to apply a mascara. For the mascara, I'm taking the Benefit They Are Real mascara. This is literally one of my favorite mascaras. Make sure that you remove the excess product in the bottle. Take the wand and slowly glide it into her fake lashes and connect it with her original lashes. We do this so that we do not see two different layers. You can just give a zigzag to the lashes. It'll automatically connect. Next, we move on to the last step of the eye makeup, that is the kajal. But for this look, I'm gonna avoid the kajal because I want the golden eyeshadow to do the talking. So all I'm gonna do is take a soft brown color below her eyes because I wanna match it well with the eyeshadow look. And just apply very minimum below her eyes. I'm taking this below the waterline, not inside the waterline. You can mix a little dark brown for the same. And that's it, I'm done with the eyes. Next, we move on to the face makeup and I'm gonna take the contour. The contour stick is by K Beauty. So I'm gonna apply extremely light contour, just a few dots, and take a beauty blender and immediately blend it off. You can also do this on the jawline. You can start from the corner of the ear and take it till the center, and same thing on this side. Just take a beauty blender and gently blend it. Lastly, I'm going to do the contouring on the nose. Make sure that you do not leave any lines while you're doing the contouring. Everything should be blended well into one another. Now you move on to the blush on. And for the blusher, I'm using the Swiss Beauty Baked Blusher and Highlighter. I'm going to take some on my brush. And while doing the blush on, I'm just going to ask her to smile a little and get the guideline really quickly. So when she smiles, the apple of her cheeks it's called, you just take your blush on there and blend it well into circular motion. Also, whenever you've done contouring, you take it in the upward direction. The same thing works with the blush on. You go in circular motions and go in the upward direction. This is going to really help lifting the face. As you see that the contouring and blush is done, and now we usually move to the highlighter. But for mature skin, I would say that avoiding a highlighter would be great because it can act as a microscope to the wrinkles and fine lines. I'm going to use the same shade as I'm going to use for the lipstick. For the lip liner, I'm using the Nykaa Lipstone Lie in the shade Heartbreaker. So while you're outlining the lips, you first start with the V. And then you go to the lower lip. Join it from all the corners. And apply it all over the lip. This trick can also help you if you want your lipstick to last for long. I like how this lip shade is complementing her outfit and her eyes. And also we are doing a festive look with some glam in it. So, you know, such colors really work well on mature skin. I'm gonna move on to the last step, that is the lipstick. For the lipstick, I'm using the Nykaa Wonder Puff in the shade Hustle and very lightly apply it on the lips. In deep tones, you can use colors in pinks, maroons, browns, or even red for that matter. All you need to know is which red is perfect for you. If you want to go for any bold colors, you really must, because there are no rules in makeup, and if you're ready to experiment something, then you should totally go for it. No makeup is complete without this step, that is applying the setting spray on the face. I'm using the Maybelline Lasting Fix Spray. And we are done. Doesn't she look gorgeous? I'm loving how the look has turned out on her. Wrinkles are your pride, but it's okay to take help of makeup to look and feel your very best at any occasion. If you have any questions, you can mention that in the comment section. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Nykaa TV for lots more. Do not forget to watch our next video where I'll be showing you an evening makeup look on mature skin. I hope you all like this video